Foods that contain vitamin D. Modern science often adds vitamins and/or minerals to processed foods. For example, vitamin D is added to most dairy products and some grains. But most vitamin D is found in animal products like fatty fish, tuna, salmon, mackerel, and beef liver. Take a closer look at the levels in different foods and supplements. Cod liver oil 1360 IU. Cooked trout 645 IU. Cooked swordfish 566 IU. Cooked salmon 447 IU. Mushrooms, white, raw, sliced and exposed to UV light, 366 IU. Tuna, canned in water and drained, 154 IU. Fortified orange juice 137 IU. Fortified milk 115 to 124 IU. Fortified soy, almond, or oat milk 100 to 144 IU. Fortified yogurt 80 IU. Sardines, caned in oil and drained, 46 IU. Scrambled egg 44 IU. Cooked beef liver 42. Egg yolk 41 IU. Fortified cereal 40 IU. Cheddar cheese 12 IU. Swiss cheese 6 IU. Portobello mushrooms 4 IU. Fruits and vegetables 0 IU. Grains and cereals 0 IU. As you can see, certain animal products contain more vitamin D than other foods. It's important to check nutrition labels to be certain how much vitamin D and other nutrients your food actually has. Fortified foods don't all contain the same amounts of vitamin D. How much do you need? In a healthy person, the amount of vitamin D you need every day is going to depend on your age. Your needs will increase over time as your body ages and becomes less capable of making and utilizing the vitamin. The following will give you general guidelines for recommended daily amounts, RDA, of vitamin D for each age range. Remember, however, that your doctor may recommend higher levels if you have vitamin D deficiency or are at risk, especially if you have osteoporosis or other bone disorders. It's important to talk with your doctor about your individual needs. Infants 0 to 6 months need 400 IU daily. Infants 6 to 12 months need 400 IU. Children 1 to 3 years old need 600 IU. Children 4 to 8 years old need 600 IU. Over 9 years old need 600 IU. Over 70 years old need 800 IU. Pregnant, lactating women, 14 to 50, need 600 IU daily. Notice the upper limits on these vitamin D amounts. Since vitamin D is fat soluble, it can build up to toxic levels in your body. This can cause some pretty serious side effects, so don't go over the daily recommended amount without your doctor's suggestion. Diagnosis and treatment. To start, your doctor will perform a blood level test to determine whether you are suffering from vitamin D deficiency. This is a simple test that involves drawing blood from a vein in your arm. You don't need to fast or prepare for this test, either. The most common one is 25-hydroxyvitamin D or 25-OD. This isn't a test that is routinely ordered for a physical, so you need to discuss with your doctor whether you are at risk and need a vitamin D level test. A blood level of 20 nanograms per milliliter, nanogram per milliliter, up to 50 nanograms per milliliter is considered to be an adequate level for most healthy people. If your blood level is less than 12 to 20 nanograms per milliliter, you definitely have a vitamin D deficiency. Your doctor will then recommend a daily intake of vitamin D-rich food or a supplement as discussed in a previous chapter of this report. A doctor can also prescribe vitamin D levels over the daily recommended amounts if you need them to get your blood levels back to normal. While you might consider eating more vitamin D-rich foods like fish or beef liver or fortified milk products, most likely your doctor will recommend a supplement for you. There are two types of vitamin D, D2 and D3. The D3 type, also known as ergocalciferol, is found in some plants. D2, or cholecalciferol, is the type that comes from animals. You'll need a prescription for D2, but D3 is available over the counter at any pharmacy. Prescription vitamin D usually comes in 50,000 IU and is designed to take once or twice a week. D3 is more easily absorbed than D2 and can last longer in your body than D3. Just make sure you follow your doctor's recommendations and avoid getting too much vitamin D. Also, keep in mind that while you can't get too much vitamin D from sunlight, If you overdo your supplements, you can get more than the daily recommended amount and cause some negative side effects like hypercalcemia, too much calcium in your blood, nausea, increased thirst and urination, constipation, and poor appetite. In extreme cases, you might cause weakness and confusion, or even ataxia, a neurological condition that makes you slur your words and suffer from clumsiness. If your doctor recommends more than the usual RDA, be on the lookout for these symptoms and let them know immediately if you have any of them. Another thing to beware of is the amount of vitamin A you're getting along with that vitamin D. Vitamin A can also build up in your body and cause toxic side effects.